we shall calculate electric field intensity. Intensity due to spherical charged shell. Spherical charged conducting shell. Now let us consider a conducting sphere. Conducting sphere. Now this is called, what to say, conducting sphere. This is the conducting sphere. Right? This conducting sphere, if the charge is given, this is the charge. This is the charge. Now, what is the radius? The radius is R. The radius is R. The radius is R. Now, that is the charged conducting sphere, whose radius is capital R. In this case also, right? You want to define surface charge density. Surface charge density. The surface charge density is represented by sigma by area. Now Q by area. What is the surface area of the sphere? The surface area of the sphere, 4 pi capital R square. Remember, sigma is equals to Q by 4 pi R square. Q is the total charge remains on the surface, and capital R is the radius of the original sphere, conducting sphere. Now in this case, we want to calculate the electric field intensity. As we want to calculate the electric field intensity, there is a point, there is a point, and there is a point. How many points are there? A point, B point, and C point. A point is outside point, B point is surface point, C point is inside point. We want to calculate electric field intensity on outside point, electric field intensity on the surface point, electric field intensity inside the point. Now, first case, case 1, outside point. Outside point. Whenever you consider outside point, whenever you consider outside point, right? Outside point. What is our sphere? This is our sphere. Right? What is the charge in the sphere? This is the charge in the sphere. Right? What is the radius of the sphere? Capital R is the radius of the sphere. What is the total charge in the sphere? Capital Q. What is the surface charge density? Sigma is equals to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught. Sigma is equals to Q by 4 pi R square. Let us consider there is a point. That point is A. Now, at this point, what is the electric field intensity? Now, imagine a Gaussian surface. Here, Gaussian surface is the sphere. Now, Gaussian surface is the sphere. This is the Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. Now, this dotted line represent Gaussian surface. Right? Now, from the center of the conducting sphere, this point is at a distance of small r. Therefore, the Gaussian surface radius is also small r. Now, this is the conducting sphere whose radius is r. Now I want to calculate electric field intensity at the point A, which is at a distance of small r from the center of the conducting sphere. Now imagine a Gaussian surface which is passing through the point A. Now what is the radius of the Gaussian surface? That is small r is the radius of the Gaussian surface. What is the radius of the conducting sphere? Capital R is the radius of the conducting sphere. What is the radius of the Gaussian surface? That is small r is the radius of the Gaussian surface. Now, what is the area of the conducting sphere? 4 pi into capital R square. What is the surface area of the Gaussian surface? 4 pi into small r square. Now, this is called original conducting sphere. Now, this is called, what to say, Gaussian sphere. The radius of the conducting sphere is capital R and radius of the Gaussian surface is small r. Now, at that point, what is the electric field intensity? To calculate the electric field intensity at this point, this is a positive charge. Electric field intensity is like this, E bar. Positive charge, radially outward. Now, consider a small area here. Consider the small area. What is the area magnitude? Ds. What is the area direction? N cap. Right. What is the angle between area vector to the electric field intensity? Theta is equals to 0. Now, what is the flux passing through the Gaussian surface? Therefore, that is phi is equals to closed integral of E ds cos theta. Therefore, phi is equals to closed integral of E ds cos theta. Theta is equals to 0, cos 0. Therefore, phi is equals to closed integral of E ds cos 0 is equals to 1. That equals to E is the electric field intensity, which is constant, you may keep outside. Therefore, closed integral of ds. Closed integral of ds, the total area represented, the Gaussian surface. Now, here in this case, phi is equals to E into, right, the total area of the Gaussian surface. Gaussian surface. What is the surface area of the Gaussian surface? This is the Gaussian surface. What is the radius? Small r. Therefore, 4 pi small r square. Now, according to Gauss law, phi is equals to q by epsilon naught. Already we calculated phi. Phi is equals to E into 4 pi epsilon r square is equals to q by epsilon naught. That implies that is E is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square. This is the electric field intensity outside point. Right? The electric field intensity at a point A, which is at a distance of small r, is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square. Now let us consider E is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught here q. Right, q is equals to that is sigma into 4 pi capital R square. Therefore, see, q is equals to sigma into 4 pi into capital R square by small r square. 4 pi gets cancelled. That is E is equals to that is sigma into capital R square by small r square. Therefore, what is the electric field intensity? Therefore, this is the another formula of electric field intensity. E is equals to sigma into capital R square by small r square. Now, this is the electric field intensity at outside point. The electric field intensity on the surface point.